It is unusual for a director of public health to publish an annual report that is wholly given over to one topic, but this year I have decided to do that, and the topic is climate change and health. This is why. Climate change is the defining public health issue of this century. In this report, I explain why that is the case, how it may affect Sheffield, and what we can do and are already doing about it. In the long term, climate change is significantly more threatening to public health than any of the other problems that we spend our time dealing with. Although smoking, physical inactivity, alcohol and so on are all major public health issues that we have to address, they are not universal in their impact and they do not threaten the fundamentals of human society. We quite rightly spend a lot of time and energy seeking to ensure the best start for our children and ensuring that they are safe. But if we do not tackle climate change effectively, their future will be very bleak. Climate change is caused by global warming, which in turn is caused by the accumulation of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Chief amongst these is carbon dioxide, or CO2, released by the burning of fossil fuels. But other gases also contribute. Average global temperatures have risen by about half a degree centigrade in the last 50 years, and by 0.8 of a degree from pre-industrial times. Each of the last three decades has been hotter than the previous one. But you don't need to take it from me. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the IPCC, says it's virtually certain that human influence has warmed the global climate system, and extremely likely that more than half of the observed increase in global temperature is related to human activity. Global warming changes the climate in a number of different ways. As well as increasing average temperatures, it increases the frequency and severity of heat waves. Warmer air carries more water vapour, so global warming increases rainfall, particularly in storms. Storms contain more energy and so are more intense, as well as being more frequent. In addition, global warming is causing melting of the permafrost, glaciers and Arctic sea ice, all of which will have the effect of further increasing the warming of the planet. The sea level is rising and the sea itself becoming more acidic. And this is a real problem when so much of the world feeds on fish. All of these changes are happening already. What happens in future depends primarily on how much greenhouse gas we release into the atmosphere, but also changes in agriculture, diet, the way we use our land, rates of economic development and population growth. The development and use of carbon capture and storage may also play a part. But first, we need to recognise that because carbon dioxide is a very long-lived atmospheric pollutant, we are already committed to significant further global warming based simply on the amount already in the atmosphere. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change has described four different scenarios for different trajectories of greenhouse gas emissions up to the end of this century. The best case scenario assumes a radical reduction of emissions starting almost immediately, which leads to a slow rate of temperature increase that plateaus at about 1 degree increase over current levels by the middle of this century. But by contrast, in the worst case scenario, with unabated greenhouse gas emissions, average temperatures will rise by 2 degrees by the middle of the century and nearly 4 degrees by the end. A heatwave summer, like that of 2003, would be a cool one. And what does all this mean for health? This report outlines briefly how climate change can threaten the health of our population. All of the key social determinants of health, food, water, shelter, even the normal function of human society, are threatened by climate change. How bad the effects will depend on how much global warming happens, which in turn depends primarily on how effectively we can collectively control greenhouse gas emissions. How we do this is the most important challenge facing human civilization. If, globally, we achieve the rapid reduction in greenhouse gas emissions necessary for the IPCC's best case scenario, the public health consequences of climate change will still be significant, but manageable. On the other hand, if we continue with business as usual, leading to a 4 degree centigrade increase in global temperatures, the public health consequences could well be catastrophic. The Lancet has recently warned that it would lead to, and I quote, a discontinuity in the long-term progression of humanity. In other words, a breakdown of society and the loss of what humankind has built up over centuries to make life worth living. Unfortunately, at the moment, global carbon dioxide emissions are increasing. Burning more than a quarter of the known fossil fuel reserves would release enough CO2 to put the world onto a trajectory of over 4 degrees of global warming. It is therefore perhaps not surprising that the World Health Organization's Director General, Dr. Margaret Chan, has stated that climate change is the greatest threat to public health and the defining issue of the 21st century. She is supported in this conclusion by both The Lancet and the British Medical Journal, which now states that the WHO should declare this to be a public health emergency. However, there are signs that an increasing number of people are recognising the dangerous position we are in and exploring ways in which a global economy has to change. There are also links between present public health problems such as obesity and air pollution and the kind of steps we have to take to tackle climate change. Many of the things we need to do to reduce greenhouse gas emissions and so to reduce the extent of climate change will benefit our health in the short term. In this report, I describe some of those things. On the 16th of September in 1948, Nye Bevan, the founder of the NHS, said in a speech to the Society of Medical Officers of Health, the forerunners of Directors of Public Health, that they should be, quote, like some watcher of the skies, for portents, not merely of epidemic disease, but of anything that likely to have an adverse effect on health. Climate change is certainly one such portent. I urge you to read my report.